I want to let you know that there's more than just coming to church. Hay algo más que nomás de ir a la iglesia. I think that a lot of the churches have never even had a bit of a glory of God. Yo pienso que muchas iglesias no han tenido, no han experimentado la gloria de Dios. And I think that a lot of the times, you know, we are so caught up and busy in our own thing that we don't allow God to move. A veces estamos tan preocupados con nuestras propias agendas, nuestras cosas, que no dejamos que Dios se mueva. We do live in a fast-paced world, right? Vivimos en un mundo rápido. But that doesn't mean that we have to go that way. Eso no quiere decir que nosotros tenemos que caminar así. And I don't know about you, but the Bible says that signs and wonders will follow us. And it's not that they're not following us right now. I believe the thing is that we have not believed God enough for them to follow us. La Biblia dice que las señales y los milagros nos van a seguir, pero no es que no nos estén siguiendo, es que no le estamos creyendo a Dios. Amen. Because he said, these things shall follow you all the days of your life. Estas señales os seguirán, dice, todos los días de nuestra vida. And we are supposed to be experimenting miracles on a daily basis. Shouldn't be a surprise for us to see a miracle. No debe ser una sorpresa para nosotros ver un milagro, because it didn't surprise Jesus. No sorprendió a Jesús, no sorprendió a los discípulos, didn't surprise them after Jesus left, because they began to work and operate in the under the glory of God. Empezaron a operar bajo la gloria de Dios. And I really do believe that if we can just desire, desear que Dios, que la gloria de Dios venga a nuestra vida, I think that our life would be a whole lot different. Yo pienso que nuestra vida sería totalmente diferente si deseáramos la gloria de Dios. ¿Cuántos quieren ver el mover de Dios? And how many of you want to see a move of God in your life? Amen. Today, I want to talk to you about revelation and manifestation of the mysteries of the glory of God. Revelation and manifestation of the mysteries of the glory of God. Revelación y manifestación de los misterios de la gloria de Dios. I want to talk to you about this, and I've been reading this book, and if you have an opportunity to buy it, amen, it's called The Glory of God by Guillermo Maldonado, un apostle de Dios. It's a real good book, amen, and I've been soaking this teaching, going back and forth through the scriptures and seeing it. And, we are living right now in an age where natural knowledge has increased dramatically. Estamos viviendo en un tiempo, mi hermano, donde la naturaleza o el conocimiento humano natural ha engrandecido. Amen. If you look around, scientists are making new discoveries. Technologies are building so many things. Tecnologías han estado creando ciertas cosas. La ciencia ha encontrado nuevas cosas. And the knowledge of the natural knowledge has expanded. La naturaleza, el conocimiento natural ha crecido. I mean, drastically. Amen. I mean, if you can just look at your phones, you know, your phones, sus teléfonos, you know, you can do everything with your phone. Everything with it. Usted puede hacer todo con su teléfono. And you know, there are things that are being created, and people, you know, están creando ciertas cosas, and the knowledge of it has, like I said, it has grown, ha crecido tanto, but just like the natural knowledge has grown, así como el conocimiento humano ha crecido, la revelación también está creciendo en estos días de Dios. Revelation from God also is increasing in the church. Amen. God is revealing himself to his people now, I believe, more than ever. Yo siento que hoy Dios está revelando a su pueblo, hoy más que nunca. In different ways, en diferentes maneras. through dreams, through visions, a través de sueños, a través de visiones, a través de su palabra, through his word. He's just revealing himself. There's so much stuff that God is, and God never meant for this to be a mystery to his children. Dios nunca ha deseado que esto sea un misterio para sus hijos. Dios siempre ha querido revelarlo. God has always wanted to reveal these things to his people. God has always wanted to make these things manifest to his people. Dios quería manifestar estas cosas para el pueblo de Dios. Amen. And he has always wanted us to know. Dios siempre ha querido, mi hermano, que nosotros sepamos esta. So we want to be able to move in the glory of God. Queremos empezar a movernos en la gloria de Dios. Amen. Why? Because things happen in the glory of God. Cosas suceden en la gloria de Dios. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? And I want you to learn this because I want you to receive and I want you to walk and I want you to feel the manifest presence of God. Yo quiero que tú camines y que recibas y que tú empieces a gozar de la manifestación de Dios. The healings, the miracles, the signs and the wonders, los señales, los milagros, las cosas que vienen en nuestra vida. I want us to begin to experiment these things. Anybody else want to do that?
Yeah.
You know, because we don't have to wait. We don't have to wait to miracle healing service on, you know, that we have once a year. God can heal you any given day. Today God can heal you. Hoy Dios se puede sanar. No tiene que ser una vez por año. And in order for us to do that is we have to have knowledge or understand the nature of the glory of God. Tenemos que entender y saber la naturaleza de la gloria de Dios. Because if you don't know the nature of a thing, you will abuse it. Hello? Si tú no sabes la naturaleza de una cosa, tú la vas a abusar. For instance, if I don't know the nature of this guitar here, si no yo no conozco la naturaleza de esa guitarra, I can grab that guitar and try to hammer something in. Puedo agarrar esa guitarra y puedo empezar a tratar de clavar algo. ¿Por qué? Porque no sé la naturaleza. If I don't know the nature, I'm going to abuse it. And that was meant to be played. The nature of the guitar is to make sound. La naturaleza de la guitarra es hacer sonido, no es para clavar. Un clavo. It's not to hammer in a nail. It's to make sound. Are you understanding me? But if I don't know the nature of it, why was it created? Si yo no conozco la naturaleza de la guitarra y no sé por qué fue creada, la voy a abusar. I'm going to abuse it. If you don't know the nature of why you were created, you abuse yourself. Hello? So, before we can start and do a lot of other stuff and more, get into the glory of God, I want to talk to you about two types of knowledge. Quiero hablarte de dos clases de conocimiento. Amen? De conocimiento. To understand what revelation is, para poder entender qué es la revelación. We first need to distinguish these two. Number one, the first thing is knowledge that comes through our physical senses. El conocimiento que viene de nuestros sentidos físicos. That's knowledge number one. Knowledge that comes through our physical senses. Conocimiento que viene de nuestros sentidos, aleluya, físicos. Number two, knowledge that is revealed. Conocimiento que es revelado. Conocimiento que es revelado. And we're going to talk a little bit about these two. And I want to teach you this because I don't want to be up here and just preach you happy and you leave out of this place dumb as a rock. I want to be able to teach you so that you can know. Okay? No quiero venir a predicarte y te salgas aquí más confundido, más, no quiero decir la palabra tonto, pero sin saber. Because if I just come up here and preach and get you all hyped up, that'll go wear out. But if I teach you to do something, that you can do it on your own, that you don't need me to be there. Are you understanding me?
Uh-huh.
That's the objective. Ese es el objetivo. Es que quiero enseñarte para que tú empieces a hacer cosas solo, para que no me necesites a mí. Amen. So, I want, if you allow me to teach, can I teach?
Yeah.
At least I'm going to try to teach. Look at your neighbor, he's telling me he's going to try. I'm not going to do it, but I'm going to try. Thank you for having that confidence in me. Number one, let's talk about the first one. Knowledge that comes from our physical senses, el conocimiento que viene de nuestro sentido físico. Vamos a hablar. The first type of knowledge is scientific knowledge and practical knowledge that comes through the senses. We talked about this. Sight, hearing, touch, smell, and taste. This is the physical one. El sentido, el conocimiento natural viene de los sentidos, de lo que miras, de lo que oyes, de lo que tocas, de lo que empiezas a oler, lo que pruebas, aleluya, de los sentidos. Amen. And you have to understand that it is information or stored data, es información, o data, aleluya, adquirida. And it implements the natural world. You need this to live in this world. Okay? But this is just one part of knowledge. Tú necesitas esta clase de naturaleza porque estamos todavía en el mundo. Can I get an amen? We're still in this world, so we need some of this stuff. But there's another knowledge that we're going to talk about a little bit later on. Hay otra naturaleza o conocimiento, sabiduría, que vamos a aprender que es más importante. Dígame en alguien, por favor. So, natural knowledge is mental knowledge. It's a naturaleza mental. Amen? In other words, you have to look for it. You have to read it. Tienes que buscarlo. Esta clase de conocimiento, tienes que leer libros. You have to read books. You have to go to school to acquire this kind of knowledge. So tienes que ir a la escuela para recibir esta clase de conocimiento. Are you understanding? Are you understanding me? You go to church to gather knowledge from different things. You have different subjects, math, science, all kinds of subjects, and you're getting information. Vas a la escuela, estás agarrando diferentes informaciones de matemáticas y ciencias sociales y otras cosas. Estás agarrando y estás recibiendo sabiduría de terrenal porque la vas a usar. You're going to use that. But they won't teach you revelation knowledge from God in school. En la escuela no te van a enseñar la revelación de Dios. La sabiduría de la revelación de Dios. Amen. So people who live according to this type of knowledge, often this is what they say. I believe in what I see, hear, feel, taste, and smell. And I believe in material things because I can see them. But I don't believe in God because I can see them. Many people don't believe in God because they can't see them, they can't feel them. Mucha gente no cree en Dios porque no lo ven, porque no lo sienten. So they base their whole life off of natural knowledge. Ellos basan toda su vida bajo la sabiduría natural. There's a lot of pastors that have natural knowledge, book knowledge, but they don't have no revelation. Yes. I know pastors, they have degrees all over the world. Tienen certificados en su pared, muchos. But they have a lot of stuff up here according to books, but they don't have no revelation. No tienen revelación del Espíritu Santo. So they base their life off of what they know, and they don't leave no room for revelation. No le dan lugar a la revelación porque tienen mucho en su mente acerca de las cosas naturales de lo que la aprendieron. Amen. So I'm not telling you not to go to school, but what I'm telling you is that there's a difference between natural knowledge and revelation knowledge from God. Hay una diferencia entre estas dos. Amen. The natural knowledge. Can I tell you something? That the miracles are outside of the mental knowledge. Los milagros están afuera del conocimiento mental, than the natural realm. People cannot understand how a miracle would happen. That's why doctors, they are so, you know, they're so studied. Sometimes, that's why they scratch their head sometimes. Right? You see, they see both of the x-rays. Miran los dos rayos X y están los doctores así. Pues aquí tienes cáncer y acá no tienes cáncer. You have cancer here, you don't have it over here. Why? Because that's not in the book. Right. ¿Sí me entiende? No está en el libro. So ellos no pueden, aleluya, comprender. And they try to reason, or they'll try to tell you what they think might have happened. Yeah. Quizás ellos te dicen lo que ellos piensan que a lo mejor sucedió. not knowing that God can do a miracle.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So, one cannot know God through mental knowledge. Una persona no puede conocer a Dios a través del conocimiento mental. Amen. No lo puedes conocer. There has to be more, amen, than just natural knowledge. God wants to reveal himself to his people. Dios quiere revelarse, mi hermano, a su pueblo. Tiene que haber más, aleluya, de la naturaleza, aleluya, que es natural. Amen. So, a lot of people just have natural knowledge. Books. Tienen libros. And listen, I have a lot of books. Yo tengo muchos libros. You go to my house, I have three shelves in my house. Tengo tres de esos. Uh-huh. And I have a lot of books in it. Tengo muchos libros. But I don't guide myself a lot of the books because I depend a lot on God. I don't have the school. I never went to ministry school. You know, nunca fui a la escuela del ministerio. Yo fui a la escuela del Espíritu Santo. I went to the school of the Holy Spirit. And all I know is Holy Spirit.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So what you get is just right here. I would love to go to school. Quisiera ir a la escuela. But right now, I don't have the time. So what I have is whatever has been deposited in me. Lo que tengo es lo que está siendo depositado en mi vida. Dígame algo. So we learned that natural knowledge is important, but it's not the only. We have to be able to have both knowledges. Tenemos que tener los dos. Amen. Number two is revealed or spiritual knowledge or revelation. Revelación. If you go with me to Romans chapter 16, verse 25 through 26. Revealed spiritual knowledge or revelation is number two. Romans chapter 16, 25 through 26. We're going to talk about the second one. Revealed knowledge or revelation knowledge. When you have it, you may say amen. Thank you, Jesus. Stay having a faith. Let me go and make some. It says like this. Now to him who is able to establish you by the gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery hidden for long ages past. Verse 26 says, but now has revealed and made known through the prophetic writings by the common of the eternal God, so that all nations might believe and obey him. But it has not, he says, he's got the revelation, it's a mystery, but now, say now, it's been revealed to us. Aren't you glad that God is revealing these things to us? Dios nos los ha revelado a nosotros. Aleluya. Thank you, Jesus. Anybody getting this revelation? So, the word revelation in these verses, la palabra revelación en estos versículos, I told you a couple of weeks ago, it's translated from the Greek word apocalypse. Es esta palabra, aleluya, es traducida en el griego apocalipsis, la palabra revelación. That's where we get the book of Revelation. Recibimos el libro de revelaciones, apocalipsis. Amen. And it means to reveal, remove the covering, to discover or manifest something that was hidden. That's what the word revelation means. Es lo que quiere decir la palabra. Revelar, remover, aleluya, una cobertura, descubrir o manifestar algo que estaba escondido. God said in verse 25, according to the revelation of the mystery that was hidden. Estaba escondido, un misterio que estaba escondido long ago. It was hidden long ago, but he said, now I'm revealing it to you. Ahora lo estoy revelando a ti. Thank you, Jesus. Revelation knowledge comes directly from the Holy Spirit.
Yes, amen.
Revelation knowledge comes from the Spirit of God directly into the spirit of man. La revelación El conocimiento, la revelación de Dios viene derechita desde el Espíritu de Dios al Espíritu del hombre. God will not talk to your mind. God will always talk to your spirit. Dios no te va a hablar a la mente. Dios te va a hablar al Espíritu. Why? Because God is
Spirit.
Dios es Espíritu. Y la única manera que se va a comunicar contigo es a través del Espíritu. So therefore we need the Holy Spirit to have that communication with our Heavenly Father. Necesitamos el Espíritu Santo para tener esa revelación con el Padre. Amen. So it comes directly from the Father to our spirit. Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 16, verse 15 through 17.
Thank you, Lord.
This revelation knowledge, you don't need to learn this. My God, this is good stuff. Let me just go. Let me just go real quick, because I don't want to lose you. But take it over that. I get excited. Anybody gets excited?
Amen.
I get excited.
Hallelujah.
15. Let's go to Matthew chapter 16, verse 15 through 17. Let's start in verse 15. This is Jesus. But what do you? He asked, who do you say I am? Remember when he asked the disciples? ¿Se acuerdan cuando Jesús le dijo a los discípulos, ¿quién dicen que soy? Verse 16. Simon Peter answered, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Tú eres el Cristo, el Hijo del Dios viviente. Whew, thank you, Jesus. And then Jesus came back and told Peter on verse 17. Jesús le dijo a Pedro en versículo 17. Jesus replied, blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for this was not revealed to you by man, but by my Father in heaven.
Yes.
This kind of revelation, Peter didn't have to go to school to get it. Esta clase de revelación que había recibido Pedro no fue a la escuela por ello.
No.
He did not have to study a book. No tuvo que estudiar un libro para recibir esa revelación. He didn't have to study a book to receive that revelation. That revelation came instantly, in the blinking of an eye.
Yes.
Esa revelación vino instantáneamente en un cerrar y abrir de ojos. ¿Quién dices que soy? Tú eres Cristo. Tú eres el Hijo del Dios viviente. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Revelation knowledge, right there and then, directly from the Spirit of God to the Spirit of Peter. Del corazón del Espíritu de Dios al Espíritu de Pedro. It was revealed quickly. Hallelujah. This kind of revelation doesn't come from books. Esta clase de revelación no viene de libros. Esta clase de revelación viene con intimidad. Con el Padre. This kind of revelation comes through intimacy with the Father. If you never get intimate with the Father, you never receive new revelation. Si tú no tienes esa intimidad con el Padre, mi hermano, aleluya, déjame decirte que tú no vas a recibir maná fresco, nuevo. Amen.
Lord, aleluya.
Can I tell you something? This is awesome. In heaven, there's not going to be no classes.
No.
En el cielo no va a haber escuela. In heaven, you don't have to sit under a teacher to try to learn what's going on in there.
Oh,
en el cielo no va a haber escuela. No tienes que sentarte bajo un maestro para aprender algo nuevo. No, en el cielo ya va a estar todo. The Bible says that everything is complete.
Yes.
In heaven. You don't need, God's not going to come and tell you, well, you know what, you can go to school, so go over there, door number 3, go sit out for about three years over there, and then you come back out. No, in heaven, there's not going to be no school. In heaven, you're just going up there to enjoy, hallelujah, the revealer. Vas a ir a ver y a gozar del revelador, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Calm down. Easy, tiger. You're not going to need a college course. You're not going to need no credits. So, you know how many pastors get so disappointed because they don't get the credits that they need to be able to obtain a diploma? But in heaven, you don't need no college credits. You don't have to go. God, I'm sorry, I'm not. Tonto, Dios, no fui a la escuela, no aprendí nada, y aquí no es. No, you don't. Praise Him because you already made it. If he tells you good, well done, good and faithful servant, just enjoy it. Forget about school. Now you can really forget about school. So, revelation is spiritual knowledge about God and his ways that comes into our spirit suddenly. La revelación de Dios viene. You know, sometimes as I'm preaching, and you see me from time to time, every once in a while, as I'm preaching, cuando estoy predicando de tiempo en tiempo, y estoy predicando algo, y luego me paro, then I stop and I say, oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Cuando digo, gracias, Espíritu, that means that he just deposits something in my spirit, and then I gotta release it. Estoy predicando y luego de repente me paro y dice, gracias Señor. Y luego cambio. ¿Por qué? Porque me acaba de dar una revelación. And I want to be able to make it. Because what God gives to me, the way he gives it to me, he might give it to you different. He might work with you different. He doesn't work with everybody the same. Can you imagine that we all were the same? This would be a boring world. Este sería el mundo. Can you imagine? We had about 1,000 Joels. Hombre, todos dormidos. Nadie trabajaba. Entonces, blame Joel. I had to throw it in there. Hallelujah. The thing about revelation knowledge from God, you know what it does? It accelerates us. Or how do you say it? It makes us go faster. It makes us go to another level. La revelación de Dios nos acelera más para frente. Why? Because in the revelation knowledge, he lets us know things that are up ahead. He lets us know things that have not yet happened yet, but he'll tell you that tomorrow something's going to happen. And you already know before you get there, because you have already been accelerated to your next day, but it is because the revelation has came upon you, and therefore you can prophesy to somebody and tell them, tomorrow about this time, somebody's going to come to your house, and they're going to bring you this, or they're going to bring you. Why? Because you have been accelerated to your next day when the other person's still on yesterday.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
The thing about it is that the enemy doesn't want us to operate in the revelation knowledge or receive revelation from God. El enemigo no quiere que recibamos revelación de Dios, porque la revelación de Dios nos acelera. Y lo que hacemos es venimos y damos profecía. Señor me dijo que el día de mañana Dios va a hacer esto y esto. Has anybody ever gotten a revelation of your tomorrow and it happens just as they said? ¿Cuándo estás recibiendo una palabra, una profecía y te dicen que va a suceder algo una semana o dos semanas y sucede como te dijeron?
Amen.
I've received that before. Yo he recibido eso. So what happens is revelation from God accelerates you, te acelera, aleluya, y podemos, aleluya, vivir en lo supernatural. We get to live in the supernatural. Say amen, somebody.
Amen, aleluya.
What happens is that revelation from God is a window that is open to us into eternity, that we can see what happens tomorrow. Have you ever gotten a vision or God deposits something in your life about your children? About your children? And you see them, amen. I believe with Pastor Garcia at one time, she said that we were up here praying for somebody, and I believe she had said that she had seen, I don't know which one, but she had seen one of Jessica's sons preaching.
Mikey.
Remember when you saw him?
Mikey.
Mikey. He saw him. In other words, what happened is God deposited something into her life that she was able to see. Are you understanding me? She was able to see, and she said, man, I saw this right here. Now, you look at it right now, and it might not look that way. Right? Am I not? Well, man, I don't think my son's going to be able to. You see how he's been right now? You see how he's acting right now? I don't think my. But see, that's the now. Yes. Es el ahorita. Quizás tu hijo no sea lo que tú has visto, lo que Dios ha depositado en tu vida.
Amen. Aleluya.
Because you're looking at the now. You're not looking at.
Come on.
No estás viendo el futuro. No estás viendo lo que Dios tiene para ti. Because God lets us know these things. Dios no. He didn't want us to. He didn't want for it to be a mystery. Él no quería que fuera un misterio. Él quería revelárselo a la gente. From the beginning. Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
So God wants to reveal himself to us humans. The thing about it is that revelation from God demands change. That's where the problem is. Because we don't want to change. La revelación de Dios siempre, siempre va a demandar cambio. Y ese es el problema. Porque no queremos cambiar. Because in change, that means you have to leave your homeboys. And you have to leave your homegirls, right? They tienes, en el cambio, a veces tienes que dejar a tus amigos y a tus amigas. And they go, Pastor, but we're tight, we're bond. We're tight, Pastor. Estamos, así somos, mis amigos. You don't know what's happening behind your back. Hallelujah. So we listen. Adam had the revelation knowledge of God in the garden. Dios, Adán tenía la revelación de Dios en el jardín del Edén. And when he sinned and he ate of the knowledge, of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, then he became dead to the spiritual realm. Cuando Adán pecó y comió del árbol del, de la ciencia, del bien y la vida, del mal, dice la Biblia que su espíritu murió. And he went from revelation knowledge to natural knowledge. Right. We are going from natural knowledge to revelation knowledge. Amen. So Adam had it made. Adam didn't know what impossibility was. It wasn't in his vocabulary. Adán no sabía que era la palabra imposible. I imagine Adam walking, he just speaks things into existence right there and then. Burro, vaca, perro, esto, pescado, esto. He's just walking and calling things up as they go. No tengo burro. He's calling things how they work. Hablándole las cosas como era. Because he had the very spirit of God. Él tenía el mismo espíritu de Dios. And God said, I'm going to give you everything that I have. To you. So Adam had the best in the garden. But sin destroyed him. El pecado lo destruyó. Y cuando entró el pecado, aleluya, he became spiritually dead. Vino a ser muerto espiritualmente. Amen. Now he's got to learn everything. Ahora tiene que aprender todo. Because now he's living in a natural knowledge. Ahora está viviendo en un mundo de naturaleza. Tiene que empezar a aprender todo. Now he has to go to school. Now he has to work. Ahora tiene que trabajar. Ahora tiene que ir a la escuela. Ahora tiene que sudar. Now he has to sweat. Now he has to tend to the kids. Ahora tiene que cambiar al niño. Ahora tiene que hacer esto. Ahora, he's got to do all these things now. Why? Because the spirit is dead. God. Jesus. The connection that he had was lost. So now he sees everything from a natural standard. Ahora ve todo de un punto natural, where his vision has been distorted. Su visión ha sido destruida. Where he can see into the future. Ya no puede ver el futuro. Y no puede recibir la revelación porque se acaba de morir el espíritu. Because the spiritual Adam had died. So Adam exchanged spiritual knowledge for mental knowledge. Adán cambió la mentalidad espiritual por la mentalidad humana. Aleluya. Can somebody say amen, please? Revelation knowledge from God erases the borders of impossibility. La revelación, mi hermano, la revelación de Dios borra toda barrera de imposibilidad. See, when you operate under the glory and the anointing of God and under the revelation of God, there is nothing that is impossible for you. Cuando operamos bajo la gloria y la revelación de Dios, no hay nada que es imposible para nosotros. That's why, under the glory of God, tumors are removed. That's why under the glory of God, limbs grow back. Por eso bajo la gloria de Dios, mi hermano, los tumores se van. Órganos, aleluya, nuevos empiezan a ser creados. New organs begin to be created under the glory of God. There is no border. There is no impossibility.
Hallelujah. Gracias, Señor.
When Jesus was walking and he was operating under the glory, cuando Jesús iba caminando y iba operando bajo la gloria, when he came to the blind man, he didn't say, well, a ver si ves, vamos a ver todos, pues tienen su mano para acá, vamos a orar por este ciego, a ver si. No, he said, go and wash yourself. There was no impossibility. No había imposibilidades.
No.
When he walked on water, cuando caminó el agua Jesús, when he walked on water, he didn't go and say, y a ver si no me hundo. Maybe I'm going to sink in. No, I believe that just like he was walking on earth, just like he was walking on the ground or on pavement, he didn't even look at the water. Ni miró el agua. Y nomás iba que he was just walking along through the river. Iba caminando. Why? Because nothing seemed impossible for him. Nada era imposible. The lame man that was sitting down by the pool of Bethesda, el ciego que estaba ahí, y luego el paralítico, he just said, get up and take up your bed and go. Can you get up? Let's see if you can get up. Try to get up. No. No le dijo, ¿verdad? A ver si te puedes levantar. A ver, Carles. A ver, mueve el otro pie. No. He just said, get up, take up your bed, and go. Are you understanding? Nosotros. A ver, camina. Mueve. Sientes el dedo. Can you feel your finger? If you feel your finger, that's good. See, we. When we don't operate under the glory, we operate under limitations. Uh-huh. Cuando no operamos bajo la gloria, operamos bajo limitaciones. Therefore, now we have to be careful, because now if we don't really believe what we're speaking, nothing's going to happen. Mm-hmm. Nada va a suceder. But Adam lived in the realm of impossibilities. Adam vivió en el ambiente de imposibilidades. There was nothing hard for him. And he traded that for natural knowledge. Y cambió eso para lo natural, la sabiduría natural. So that's why I said, listen, we need to desire the glory of God. Debemos de desear la gloria de Dios. Why? Because we want to do that. If somebody comes in a wheelchair, we don't have to fight there 2 hours. She said, get up from there. Get up and get behind that wheelchair and push it out, because you don't need that no more. Are you understanding? ¿Sí me entiende? Where we don't have to wrestle and let the enemy come in and say, no, 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 no se va a levantar. That's the first thing the enemy does. Lo único que te dice el enemigo. And the people, you know, they're like this. A ver si se levanta. Si no se levanta, es un falso profeta. Right? If you don't get up, that's a false teacher. That's a false pastor. Because it's not that the pastor, it's not that. Because a lot of the times, not only does the people don't believe, but the person that is being prayed for does not believe, so he doesn't get his miracle. No recibe su milagro. Dígame, Daniel.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
Revelation knowledge gives us access to the spiritual world, and it elevates our faith to another dimension. La revelación, aleluya, nos da acceso al ambiente espiritual, aleluya, y nos levanta nuestra fe, aleluya, y lo levanta y pasa lo imposible. That is awesome. Thank you, Jesus. Does anybody want to walk in the impossibility? ¿Alguien quiere caminar en lo imposible? God wants to reveal himself to his people. Dios quiere revelarse a su pueblo, hermano. God wants to talk to his people. Dios quiere hablarle a su pueblo. Let me tell you something. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 1, the Bible says that in the days of Eli, en los días de Eli, dice la Biblia, que la palabra de Dios no era revelada. There was no word of God. In 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 1, la palabra de Dios dice, en el 1 Samuel capítulo 3, uno mira lo que dice, look at what it says. And the child Samuel ministered unto the Lord before Eli, and the word of the Lord was precise or precious in those days. There was no open vision. In other words, there was no word of God in those days. No había palabra de Dios. Can you imagine living in a world where God don't speak? ¿Se imagina vivir en un mundo donde Dios no habla? It's sad to say that there's churches that God don't talk.
Yeah.
Other scripture says that the word of God was rare in those days. Otra versión de la palabra dice que la palabra de Dios era rara en esos días de Eli. In other words, the lamp was going out. The light was going out. La luz, la lámpara, se estaba apagando. Amen? It's very important, church, that we understand the word of God. Muy importante entender esto. So what happened? God spoke to Samuel. Dios le habló a Samuel. And because the word of God was rare in those days, and Samuel did not know the word of God, he ran to Eli. Porque la palabra de Dios no se había hablado en esos días por años. Samuel no conocía la palabra de Dios. Y dice la Biblia que cuando Dios le habló a Samuel, Samuel corrió hacia Eli. And what did he say? Here I am, master, did you call me? ¿Qué le dijo? Aquí estoy, man. ¿Me hablaste? No, vete a dormir, estás oyendo cosas.
Yeah.
Go to sleep, you're listening, you're hearing things, go back to sleep. Lleva otra vez a dormirse, he goes back to sleep. Y otra vez Dios le habla.
Yeah.
Y viene corriendo otra vez. You remember, ¿sí sabe la historia?
Yeah.
And he goes back. Y no le dice nada hasta la tercera vez. You know what? I think it's the Lord calling me. Because even Eli, for him, it was rare that the voice of God was being spoken in those days. That is sad. Qué triste es vivir una vida donde la palabra de Dios no está siendo revelada. Alabado sea el nombre de Jesús. Si Dios no está hablando, la gente se descontrola. Por eso la gente vive como vive, porque Dios no está hablando. And it's not that he doesn't want to talk, it's just he doesn't have nobody to hear. Dios quiere hablar, pero no tiene gente que le escuche. Amen. Because our agenda is full. Nuestra agenda está llena. Amen. So, because we lack revelation knowledge, there's consequences. Hay consecuencias, mi hermano. Hay consecuencias cuando no tenemos revelación de Dios. Go to Proverbs chapter 18, Proverbs 29:18. I don't know what kind of scripture, what kind of version you have in your Bible. But I got three of them that I'm going to give you. Tres versiones de la Biblia que te voy a dar. Proverbs 29:18. Where there is no revelation knowledge, people are uncontrolled and immortalized. Donde hay no hay revelación de Dios, la gente está fuera de control y está demoralizada. 29:18 says, where there is no vision, the people perish. Donde no hay visión, el pueblo padece. Another version says, where there is no word from God, people are uncontrolled. Donde no hay palabra de Dios, otra versión dice, la gente está fuera de control. The NASB says, without prophecy, the people become demoralized. Donde no hay profecía, la gente viene a ser demoralizada. The Hebrew word for the word vision or word and prophecy. The Hebrew word, la palabra hebrea para la palabra visión, palabra y profecía. In the Hebrew language, it's called chazon, which is C-H-A-Z-O-W-N, chazon, which can also mean revelation, oracle, divine communication, comunicación divina, revelación. Esto es lo que quiere decir la palabra que estamos leyendo. That is what the Word of God says. In other words, chazon means fresh revelation from God. Quiere decir revelación fresca de Dios. Meaning, God's going to give you something new today. He's not going to give you yesterday's manna. Dios no te va a dar el maná de ayer, te lo va a dar fresco ahorita. And he's not going to give you tomorrow's manna, he's going to give it to you today. He gives you today. Él te da lo de ahora. The thing about God is that the word that comes directly from God into your spirit is called rhema. R-H-E-M-A. R-H-E-M-A, la palabra rema quiere decir palabra de Dios directa desde el corazón de Dios al corazón del hombre o al espíritu del hombre. Rema means word from God, from His spirit to the spirit of man. There's nothing in between, no hay nada entre medio, es palabra rema de Dios. New revelation. Thank you, Jesus. You know why He doesn't give you tomorrow? Because tomorrow's got another one for you. Él no te da la revelación de mañana o el maná de mañana porque mañana tiene algo nuevo para ti. Gracias,
yes.
Señor. Thank you, God, that He always looks out for us. Say amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Revelation of the Holy Spirit. Without the Shazon, sin la palabra, sin la sabiduría, la gente está fuera de control. People are uncontrolled, they're lost, they're without destiny, they're demoralized, they're confused, está confundida. What do we see in this world right now? ¿Qué es lo que estamos viendo en este mundo? People are confused. La gente está confundida. Amen. Yeah. They don't know they're going or coming. Mucha gente no sabe si va o viene. They are so confused because there's no chesón, there's no word of God, there's no revelation, no hay revelación de Dios. La gente está confundida. They think there's something else that they're not supposed to be. Piensa que son otra cosa que no son. They think they're men when they're women. Confused. ¿Qué no quiere decir eso? La gente está confundida, no tiene revelación. They don't have no revelation. Darkness, that's all they have. Amen. Tienen confusión, tienen oscuridad, aleluya. People are destroyed. La gente está destruida. Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. Hosea capítulo 4, versículo 6. Dice la palabra: My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Mi pueblo padece por falta de sabiduría. And listen to what it says. Because you have rejected knowledge. I want you to listen to this. It says, because you have rejected knowledge, I will reject you from being priest to me. God. Listen to what it says. I need you to really understand this word. Where am I at? 4:6. What am I doing? It says, dice, pues por falta de conocimiento mi pueblo ha sido destruido. Pues yo, por puesto que rechazaste el conocimiento, yo también te rechazo como mi sacerdote. If you refuse or if you reject knowledge, divine knowledge from God, God is going to reject you. Si tú rechazas el conocimiento, I feel for the people, and I don't want to talk about churches, but I feel for churches that they don't give God the opportunity to move or the Holy Spirit to bring fresh revelation or manna to their life. God said, if you reject the knowledge that I'm about to give you, I'm going to reject you. Si tú rechazas el conocimiento que yo te quiero dar, la revelación, dice Dios, yo te voy a rechazar como sacerdote. But he doesn't stop there. No para ahí. He said, because you have forgotten the law of your God, I will also forget not only you, but he says, I will forget your children. Porque te has olvidado de la ley de tu Dios, dice, yo también me cuidaré, no de ti, yo me olvidaré de tus hijos. Wow. This is hard. This is palabra. If you forgive me, I'll forget you. If you forget my word, I'll forget your children. Which is your precious jewels, your treasure. Tu tesoro, son tu tesoro. Si tú te olvidas de mí, yo me olvido de tus hijos. That's what he's saying. So we should not despise the revelation from God. That's why here, you know why a lot of people, you know, we move under the anointing, under the Holy Spirit. Not a lot of churches do that. A lot of them will have an agenda. Muchas iglesias tienen una agenda. I don't have an agenda. I don't have to preach. Yo no tengo que predicar. Are you understanding me? If God moves, let him move. And I'll step out of the way. And let him do whatever. I don't want him to reject me. I don't want him to forget my children. Yo no quiero que él me rechace ni que se olvide de mis hijos. I want to let him do whatever he wants. And I want to be able to hear what he has to say to me.
Yes. Amen. Hallelujah.
Lack of revelation knowledge leads to destruction. Lack of revelation knowledge leads to destruction. La falta de sabiduría, de conocimiento, de la revelación, nos va a llevar a la destrucción. That's what the prophet Hosea warned us. He warned Israel about this crucial thing. Él le dio, aleluya, un aviso a Israel acerca de esto. Amen. God gave them the path to go. Dios les dio el camino para cual ir en el desierto. He gave them the path. He told them what to do, but they refused to do it. Él les dio el camino, las leyes para cómo ir, pero ellos, mi hermano, aleluya, decidieron no seguir ese camino. The enemy will always come in and destroy you in an area where you lack knowledge.
Yeah.
El enemigo siempre va a venir a destruirte en una área donde no hay conocimiento. Where you don't have no knowledge, there's darkness. Where you don't have no, donde no hay conocimiento, hay oscuridad. Can I tell you something? Satan is not in hell. Satanás no está en el infierno. Can I tell you where he's at? He got cast down and he's in darkness. Él está en la oscuridad, las tinieblas. Tinieblas significa oscuridad. That's where Satan is. So every area of your life that there's darkness, Satan dwells there. Cada área de tu vida donde hay la oscuridad, ahí es donde está Satanás. And the moment that knowledge comes in about that certain area, Satan has to flee because light has just came in to that area. Donde quiera que haya oscuridad, cuando viene la palabra de Dios, because the word of God is light. So right now what I'm doing, I am bringing the light out to your dark areas so that Satan can live, lead your life, and you will not perish for lack of knowledge. Lo que estoy haciendo es trayendo sabiduría o la luz de Dios a tus lugares oscuros para que no padezcas por falta de sabiduría. You can't leave this place and say, I don't know anything, I've never learned anything in that place. No, that's because you weren't paying attention. Because there's a lot of word coming out of this house. We got ministers that have brought a lot of word. And if you leave out of this place not knowing a thing, it's not the preacher's fault.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Si te vas de aquí, mi hermano, y no conoces y no sabes nada, no es la culpa del pastor o es la culpa de los predicadores. Porque tenemos predicadores que han predicado palabra de Dios. And they brought good words. It's because we have not put that word to work. So we still remain in darkness. So any area, wherever darkness is, regions, the enemy rules.
That's right.
El enemigo, mi hermano, gobierna todo lo que es oscuro. That's why Jesus said, I am the light of the world. And I'm coming to bring light to your dark areas so you won't be, so you won't perish, so that you can have light. Because what you know today is going to help you.
Right.
Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Ooh, this is good stuff.
Yeah.
Are you getting something?
Yeah.
Look at your neighbor, tell him, because he looks kind of scared. Tell him, are you getting something for real?
Yes, I am.
It is sad that in a lot of places where God is where they have churches, it's sad that the light it's going out. It's so dim. La luz, hermano, se está oscureciendo en muchos lugares. Because God has no, they don't let God. You know, I've gone to churches where, you know, if they're having a service and the Spirit of God is moving on a person over there, they'll get that person and they'll take them to another room because they don't want them to disturb the service. I've seen that. I've been in churches like that. Yo estaba en iglesias de eso. It's sad. In other words, what they're saying, God, we don't have time for you right now because we got an agenda to go to or to go by. So just take her and just go, let her have her way or have her moment over there, and then when she gets through, let her come back. That's sad. Very, very sad. Go to 1 Samuel chapter 1, again, verse 3. Look at your neighbor and tell him, don't let the light die down in your life. 1 Samuel chapter 1, chapter 3, I'm sorry, verse 1, and then I'm going to read 1, 2, and 3. Chapter 3, verse 1, 2, and 3. Listen to what it says. It says, and the child Samuel, we read this right now, ministered unto the Lord before Eli, and the word of the Lord was precious in those days. There was no open vision. Verse 2. And it came to pass at that time, when Eli was laying down in his place, and his eyes began to wax dim, that he could not see. There was no light. Verse 3. And the lamp of God went out in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of the God was, and Samuel was laying there. Let me read it. I don't know if this, my version is probably a little bit different than this one here, or not, but It says that the light in the temple, that's how when the light in the temple is up. It's sad. The lamp of God, verse 3, the lamp of God had not yet gone out. And Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord where the Ark of the Covenant was. Eli, he was already old. Elías estaba viejo. La lámpara, porque no había palabra, because there was no word, there was no revelation. The light was going dim. The light was going out. So God wanted to bring fresh manna. God wanted to light that place up again. Dios quería alumbrar ese lugar otra vez. It is sad to see leaders without revelation or fresh knowledge from God. Amen. Their ministries or their life are irrelevant. Leaders without revelation or fresh knowledge from God for their ministries will become irrelevant. Los líderes que no tienen revelación nueva de Dios, mi hermano, sus ministerios, sus vidas vienen a ser como nada. We need revelation from God. But people perish for lack of direction, for lack of vision, for lack of genuine prophetic word, revelation from God. Mi pueblo padece por falta de dirección, de visión, de sabiduría, de revelación, de palabra profética. Amen. We need, church, the revelation from God. We need to start living in the glory. Tenemos que desear vivir en la gloria de Dios. Recibir revelación de Dios. Receive revelation from God. The purpose and the importance of revelation. You know what the purpose, the main purpose of revelation is? To lead us to a supernatural experience in God's presence. So that we can be transformed. La razón, el propósito principal para la revelación es para que nos empiece a guiar a una experiencia supernatural con Dios y que haya cambio en nuestra vida. We need the revelation from God. Necesitamos la revelación de Dios. Necesitamos rema. We need rainbow word. We need an outward. Does anybody need an outward? We need an outward. I need an outward for my life. You need an outward for your life. God wants to reveal himself to you. Dios quiere revelarse a ti. Can you give God an opportunity to reveal himself in your life? ¿Le puedes dar a Dios una oportunidad de que se revele en tu vida hoy? How many of you want to see glory? ¿Cuántos quieren ver gloria? I believe, yo creo, mi hermano, que debemos de empezar verdaderamente a vivir una vida íntima con Él. I believe that we really need to start living an intimate life or an intimate relationship with God. Church, there's so many things happening around this world. Hay muchas cosas que están sucediendo en este mundo. God wants to listen. Thank you. He brought the scripture to me right now. And I've said this scripture before. He said in his scripture that the world is waiting for the sons of God to be revealed. El mundo es esperando que los hijos de Dios sean revelados. Why? Because listen, in your job, God wants to reveal himself to you in your job. Dios quiere revelarse en tu trabajo, a ti. Can you imagine you working in your job, tú trabajando, and then God drops something in your spirit right now, y Dios deposita algo en tu espíritu ahí mismo, and he says, go tell that person that if he doesn't do this, tomorrow something can happen. Or let him know that tomorrow he needs to get on his knees or whatever. God will bring you something, but if we don't have that direct communication from God, you know, that person can be destroyed. And then you're going to be there. You're going to hurt. Tú vas a doler. And I've said this before, and I'll say it again. When I used to work at Capco, when yo trabajaba en Capco, it was on a Friday night, and I had a friend of mine, un amigo mío. We were at the tour room, and we were about to go, and there was about 10 minutes for us to leave, como 10 minutos antes de salir. Y estábamos donde estaban todas las herramientas, y íbamos a sacar una herramienta. We were going to go take out some tools for the next day, para el siguiente día. And it was on a, I know it was on a Friday, era un viernes. And this guy came to the door where I was at, and we started talking. Esta persona vino a la puerta y estaba, empezamos a hablar. And the Lord, right there and then, you know, he spoke into me to just to let him know that God loves him. Solamente que le dijera que Dios lo amaba. But I didn't do it. I failed to let him know that God loved him. Yo, because of not because I didn't want to, but because I got so busy, the tools came, so I left, me fui, me dieron la herramienta y me fui, and I didn't tell him, no le dije ahí. That person, esa persona, that night, when he got home, got drunk, drugs, and he went and he killed this one lady with a hammer. Mató a una persona con un martillo. And when I saw that night, I saw it on the news, and I saw his face, the Lord brought conviction to my life right there. And Dios me trajo convicción en ti. Because that one word that I could have spoken over his life, esa palabra que hubiera yo hablado su vida, hubiera hecho un cambio. But you know what he did? He got so drugged up, and he killed this one lady. And now he's sitting behind bars. How did that make me feel? Miserable. Me hizo sentir miserable. Porque yo hubiera podido, y no es que yo sea, no, pero cuando la palabra de Dios viene, when word of God comes, you gotta release it. Tú tienes que soltarla. That's why I stop every once in a while and say, okay, God, so I gotta release it. Why? Because that word can be make a difference in your life. Esa palabra puede hacer una diferencia en tu vida. Are you understanding me? So imagine if we live a life under where there's no revelation. This whole earth, imagine, Perry Stone is a prophet of God, es un profeta de Dios, and he's constantly coming on media saying, this is what the Lord is showing me, esto es lo que me está enseñando el Señor, this is what the Lord is showing me about this earthquake, me enseñó de estos terremotos, me enseñó de esto, and we need this kind of warnings in our life. Necesitamos estas clases de advertencia en nuestra vida. Why? Because that's the only thing that's going to drop us to our knees. Estas son las únicas cosas que nos van a hacer que doblemos rodillas. If you don't get on your knees because of what you see out there, then I don't know what's going to get you to your knees. Si lo que está sucediendo en el mundo ahorita no te hace que te doble rodillas, yo no sé qué va a hacer. Maybe because it hasn't happened here, but can I tell you that they are predicting a big earthquake to happen in Wyoming? Big earthquake. That's going to happen in Wyoming. Un terremoto grande, grande que va a suceder en Wyoming. And the government, listen, the government bought property and already has tents prepared for that people because they're getting ready for that earthquake. And it hasn't even happened. No ha sucedido, pero el gobierno ya sabe, y ellos ya compraron terreno, y ya pusieron puras como casitas para la gente esa que se vaya a vivir allí. God has given us, God never wanted this to be a mystery to us, He wanted to reveal it to us. Dios nunca quiso que esto fuera un misterio, Dios quería revelárnoslos a nosotros. What you do with what God gives you, that's up to you. But there's consequences that we don't do what we're supposed to do. Hay consecuencias. Tú haces lo que tú quieras con lo que Dios te ha dado. Pero hay consecuencias si tú no haces lo que Dios te dijo que haces. Because every one of us has to give God an account for what He has told us to do. Amen. I don't know what He's been telling you. Yo no sé qué te ha dicho Dios a ti. But in the day of judgment, you will give God give an account to God for what He told you to do and you didn't do. I truly believe that God is speaking to us today. Dios nos está hablando. All these things that are happening, it's only for us to get on our knees. That's all it is. God will find a way to get us back on our knees. We have power, church. We have authority. The realm of impossibilities. El nivel de las imposibilidades. Elijah, can I end with this? Elijah walking And he told the son, son, stand still. Dios, sol, no te muevas. But then he came. Ahora no va a llover por ciertos años. It's not going to rain for some. And everything he was speaking to obeyed what he was saying. Because he was walking in the realm of glory. Estaba trabajando, operando bajo la gloria.
Amen.
This past Saturday, I think it was Saturday or Friday, last Sunday, when that big storm happened in the hail, the baseball size hail was happening, and it happened in church. Sister, Brother Robert called me up and said, Pastor, I just want to let you know that you guys are going to get hit real hard. And I looked at, and we looked at the news, and I might have said this already, but I'll say it again. And we looked at the news, and the eye of the storm was right. It was going to hit over Seguin. And the meteorologist said, you're going to get, Seguin is going to get hammered with hail. And Brother Robert called me and said, we just got hit, and our cars and our house got messed up, and all of our cars got messed up. And because of the size of the hail, he goes, and y'all better be ready because it's coming. You know what I did? We turned off the TV. I told my wife, I want all of us to get together. Let's pray. Let's pray. And we started praying. And then, you know, I did. I walked out of my house, and it was raining real hard. It was storming real hard. There was light and everything. And I walked outside. And you know what I did? I started speaking to the storm. And I said, in the name of Jesus, you are not coming into the city. There's not going to be not one little bit of that hail going to hit Seguin in the name of Jesus. So I command you to stop. I'm not going to send you nowhere else. I'm not going to send you to another city. You're just going to die down in the name of Jesus. I went outside and I began to speak and pray with authority on this storm. And you might think, no, it's coincidence. You can call it whatever you want, but I know what happened. I know what happened. And up to this day, I can tell you this, that it has not came to my ears that one piece of hail fell in Seguin. Why? Because we have power and authority to do this when we operate under the glory, that there's nothing impossible. Jesus said, speak to the storm. And that's what I did. And just like me, you can do it.
Amen.
So thank God. But we need, listen, we could have stayed and, you know, we could have came in. But in that moment, I felt God said, you need to go outside. That moment that Robert, I received and I hung up with him, the Lord said, no, you got to go outside. And I remember the scripture when the disciples were on the boat. And Jesus said, oh, you have little faith. I said, no, that's not going to be me. I'm going to go outside. Church, Lord is speaking to us. He's speaking to us. Can we stand to our feet? Hallelujah. God is good.